Hello guys, this is ETB Designs and today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on how to create this simple e-flyer here. I'm going to be working on the raw PSD file and also with the layers. So let me toggle off these layers for you to see where I started from. Okay. I'm going to be working with this image here, so you can put in any of your image you want to work with. After which I created my gradient fill, look at it. Okay, let me, normally it was at like this. So what I did was that I used my, okay, let me show you, I used my eyedropper tool. Eyedropper tool is used to select colors from your image, you can see. So I set my foreground color, this is my foreground color. So this, let me pick this color here. And my background color to this background. So select this and click OK. So let me hide this. Let me hide this. Let me just set it back to color. Okay. Let me hide this. Then what I did was I used my rectangle tool. I drew across it. Okay. It automatically fills it with what I have in this my field, but let me just leave it like this. I double click this layer, it brings up my layer style. I clicked on my gradient overlay and you can see it automatically drops what is on my color. Yeah, so I wish this I wish it was like this. What you do is that you click here, click on your color, click on your background color, click OK, click at this point, click on your color and click on your foreground color and click OK. Click OK here. Then this is where you can change your style. Well, to you can try radial. You can see how radial looks like. You can change your angle, you can try reflected, you can try diamond, you can just play around with it. This reverse, but I think I will leave mine at linear and change my angle to -90. Okay, and I'll click OK. So that was how I was able to create this gradient fill, and then I click on my move tool, then right click here and create layer, right click on your gradient overlay at this point and create layer. It automatically creates a new layer for this gradient fill. Now I can hide this, then release, click at this my rectangle, this my layer, and release clipping marks. Okay, so that was how I was able to create this gradient fill layer. Yeah, okay. Then I set my gradient, my mood, I set my mood to color. You can see how it blends the color to this image here. So I made a duplicate of this gradient fill here. But I set my mood to multiply. You can see it makes it to be more, a little bit more darker. Same thing here, yeah also. All I changed the moods to multiply. Then I added my hue saturation from my adjustment layer. Click on my hue saturation here, then to bring out this layer. Then let me show you. Then I set my hue to about +149, but you can try out other hue. You can see it gives different tunes. You can see how it looks like. You can see different tunes, but let me go back to 149. Okay, after which I added my lute. You can see it makes it to be a little bit brighter. Okay, I'm going to drop this loot in the description so that you can download it. So after downloading, you just come to your adjustment layers and click on color lockup, then load 3D loot. Then mine is at the desktop, so you click on it and load. So it automatically loads it on your Photoshop. Then after I added my text and logo to it, okay, let's see the name of this font. I use Big Noodle Titling and a size of 105. Okay, same thing here. Also, I added a rectangle to it and also a write-up, same font name. And here the musician, I used a font of Glacier Indifference. Then this is my logo. Thereafter, I added the social media handle and also, okay, these are dots. What I did, I created a new layer, took up my text to click and click on my full stops. Sorry, click my full stop. Okay, you can see. So I just made it duplicate of the full stop. You can see. So that was how I was able to create these dots here. Let me open the layer for you to see. You can see I just made duplicate of it. Then next in line is this flare. You can see it makes the image to pop out a little bit. Okay, what I did was I created a new layer, take up my eyedropper tool and click this point here. You can see, then use your brush tool. You can increase the size of your brush here, then just click on it. You can see, then I adjusted it a little bit with Ctrl T, then adjusted it, then set my mood to linear dodge add. You can see. So that was how I was able to create this flare light to it. Let me delete this and go back to my original layer. Next in line is what I did was I just created my rectangle. Then I think I applied this color. Okay, no, let me select the exact color to it using my eyedropper tool. Okay, now I can go back to my rectangle tool and click on the color. You can see. Then I created another rectangle tool, or let me just duplicate this layer, Ctrl J to duplicate. Then bring this down. Okay, then change my, let me select this color with my eyedropper tool, then change my rectangle to this. You can see, same thing for this white also. Ctrl J to duplicate this layer, then bring it down. Then drag the rectangle out. Then change the color to white. You can see. So what I did was I just grouped it. I selected the three of them using either use them control, hold your control and click, or you click here, come down, hold your shift, click. So you just select the three. Then group it, Ctrl G to group, then Ctrl E to merge it, because I want to work on these rectangle tools, these objects. And what I did was I set, okay, I went to my filter, I went to my distort and clicked on my waves. I've forgotten the exact figures I used here, but I can just play around with it to give you your own results. Then let me click okay. So this gives me another result, but you can just play around with it. So that was how I was able to create something like this. Then let me delete this and go back to my okay. I just made a duplicate of this also and applied the same effect to these. Next in line here is that I created my rectangle using my rectangle tool. I drew with fill black and I set my opacity to around 55, you can see. Then I dropped my text here. I think I'm done with this tutorial. So this was how I was able to create a simple e-flyer. Then I just like my image to have a border, so what I did was I saved this file as a JPEG, then brought in this border, this background to it. Initially it was like this, so what I did was I go to my filter, I went to my blur and I added a Gaussian blur to it. So let me just show you. Okay, this was the output. Then I brought in that my saved JPEG picture. I now dropped it like this and I scaled it. So this was how I was able to get this stylish border to it. If you like this, if you have any question, you can drop it at the comment box below. And if you like this tutorial, make sure you like and share and also subscribe to this YouTube channel. Thank you.